the word you hear that cleanses your mind. When your mind has been cleansed, your life is holy. If you are not taught who Christ is, you cannot live an effective Christian life. There is no other honor greater than that of sonship. Worldliness is the trap that enslaves men to the devil.
Relationship with God is a gift. Fellowship is a choice. The true expression of divine love is forgiveness to others. What you pursue is an expression of what you desire.
Daniel chapter 5 verse 11 and 12. There is a man in your kingdom. In him is the spirit of who? The Holy God. And in the days of your father, light and understanding and wisdom, like the wisdom of the gods, were found in him. And King Nebuchadnezzar, your father the king, made him chiefs of the magicians, astrologers, Chaldeans, and soothsayers. Inasmuch as an excellent spirit, knowledge, understanding, and interpreting dreams, solving riddles, and explaining enigmas were found in this Daniel, whom the king named Belteshazzar. Now, let Daniel be called, and he will give the interpretation. The secret of relevance. Amen. The king had a dream, and there was no one that could interpret the dream. And while the king was in this confusion, some people walked up to the king and said, "We know a man that can interpret your dream." Relevance. Your recommendation in destiny depends on your relevance to men. People don't recommend irrelevant people. If you must be recommended, you must be relevant. Daniel was so relevant that even his enemies recommended him because they knew that he was relevant. Are you relevant? That is the grace that the Lord wants to impart on you this morning. The anointing to be what? Relevant. Imagine an issue in a kingdom. There was no one that could interpret it. But they said there is a man. His name is Daniel. He is relevant. He is relevant. Friend, by grace, every youth has been empowered to become relevant to his generation. The reason why we are irrelevant is because we don't know, or we are too lazy to obey the principles that bring forth the relevance. You must not be irrelevant. Your absence must be felt because there is something you add by your presence. You must become relevant. One of the oppressions of the devil in our generation is to hinder the relevance of youths by distracting them with social media. Social media is making many youths become irrelevant. All they think about is to get money to put data in their phone to subscribe to a bundle and start browsing. They're on WhatsApp, they're on Facebook. But I want to say something. You can be on Facebook and you're relevant. Your presence on Facebook can give you money. On WhatsApp can bring you money. But if you listen, when you understand relevance, no relevant person can be poor. Are you following me? The true secret of prosperity is called the principle of relevance. When you are relevant, men will look for you. People look for relevant people. Daniel did not look for the king. The king, they said, go and look for a man. I've studied through scripture and I realized if there is something that every youth that became great had, it was relevance. When you go back, you check, one of our inspirations as a youth is Joseph. Joseph was a youth. And the king had a dream. And the king said, who can interpret the dream? All the magicians came. Nobody could interpret the dream. Then somebody said, there is one Joseph in prison. Even if he is in prison, if you are relevant, you can. Oh my God. He was in prison. Yet somebody recommended a prisoner to a king. I know a man in prison. That man can interpret in this world. Nothing makes you relevant like your ability to provide solution to the problems of the world. Anytime you have a solution, you can't be poor because your prosperity is in your solution. You are created to solve a problem. What are you solving? There is something called the ecosystem, if you have done biology or even geography. Ecosystem is what creates balance. That is why there are some animals you don't like, but they are there because they bring balance in the ecosystem. Are you following me? They bring balance in the ecosystem. Now, the relevance of each creation of God is defined by the solution it brings in the world. What are you bringing? Are you a burden or are you a blessing? Are you a solution? There's one thing. If you are not bringing solution, then you are part of the problem. There is no other way. As a you, listen to me. If you want to be great, there is one law of greatness. Solution. No matter how you do, no matter what you do, till I leave this earth, men will look for me. Because there is something I'm bringing. I carry a solution to a particular problem. When something I'm going to say, call for Prophet Kevin. Why? Not because they love me. You have no choice but to love my solution. Even if you will hate me, you can't hate the grace. Because you need the grace to become what you need to be. So if you build yourself up, one of the things I like you to understand is that nobody was created to accompany others on earth. Every man has a specific purpose for creation. There is something only you can do that I can do. No matter how prophetic I am, there is something you can do. So God enables us by various talents and gifts to become relevant. But today, everybody wants to prophesy. You may be called to be a footballer. You may be called to be an actor. You may be called to be a musician. You may be called to be a doctor, a minister, a president. Your relevance would be by functioning in your area of calling. No matter how much you admire and desire the gift in others, no gift is as good as the one that God gives you. Stay in your lane. Work on yourself and take over the world. He said there is a man who is relevant. No matter what we want to do, Mr. King, we need this man to solve the problem. How relevant are you? Look at Joseph from the prison. There was a time in 1 Samuel chapter 16, the story is there. Saul had an evil spirit, and Saul was possessed by an evil spirit, and Saul was so tormented, and somebody said, he said, my king, let us look for a man. When the demon comes in you, he will play the harp and the demon will go. And somebody walked up. Listen, this is a cabinet meeting at the palace, at the king. And somebody says, there's one guy called David. David is not there. In fact, David is in the bush. David's family is a poor family. And David is in the bush taking care of sheep. Yet, they are calling his name at the presidency. That is relevance. Where in your absence, your relevance creates your presence. You are not there, but your relevance makes you say there is somebody. If we need to plait hair, can we call you to plait hair? There can be many hairdressers, but when you become relevant, people can travel from one town to come and plait hair to you. How relevant are you? It isn't to me, as a child, as a youth, if you go after money, you will be poor and you'll be sorrowful. And in fact, if you go after money, you'll be forced to compromise your godly standard, because it is the law of this earth. You will only get money at the expense of your soul. But if you go after purpose, money is in purpose. There is nobody that becomes great and becomes great by pursuing money. But I can tell you, anybody that fulfills purpose cannot be poor. Go for relevance. Go for relevance. Whatever you are doing, do it well. This is a Daniel. David is in the bush, yet at the palace. Listen, let's talk about this. David knows nobody in the palace. He has no connection. He knows nobody there. But by reason of his excellence in his gifts, these are people in the palace talking about a poor shepherd in the bush. There is one guy. There is one girl in the market. That girl can play there. Let's go there. There is one guy. That guy can sew. Let's go there. No matter. I believe they were more. Listen to me. Funnily, the king in the palace had at least 100 musicians. That's how the palace was. So that nation had at least 7,000 musicians. Yet they left all of them. I went to one man. Listen to me. It's not about your gift too. Until your gift becomes relevant to men, nobody recommends you to high places. How relevant are you? What can you do? Stop thinking all about money. Don't think about fame. Think about adding a weight to your generation. What have you come here to do? What are the footprints you will pass on this earth? What have you done? What will you implement that they know by reason of your coming on earth? This is what happened because this man was here. Can I tell you something? Your relevance to men depends on the value you add to their life. If you have no value for me, you are irrelevant. Matter of fact, the Bible says it. Matthew chapter 5, verse 14, 15. It says, you are the salt of the earth. Wait. But if salt has lost its taste, it is good for nothing. But it shall be trampled by men and thrown away. So the value of salt is what? The taste. So it is the taste of salt that makes salt relevant. It's not the shape. It's not the size. It's the taste. When salt has lost that relevance, it becomes useless. So stop saying, nobody has my time. Nobody has the time of irrelevant people. When you lack relevance, you beg for attention. When you have relevance, you command attention. Look at all of you as you now listening to me. This is what they call relevance. Nobody is talking. All of you are quiet. If I say stand, all of you stand. If I say sit, you will sit. Why? Because I am relevant to you. You are giving me your attention. You must give me attention because you know I have something you need. That cannot shock you. There is something you also have that can make me sit down and listen to you. You must know that thing and stand there. There is an area of your life where me, Prophet Kevin, I have to sit down and listen to you and also give you my attention. I go to the barber. I obey him. Bend your head. I bend it. Put it here. Put it here. I don't have any choice. No matter how anointed I am, when I go to the barber salon, it is his ministry. I must. He is so relevant to me. And now, no, not everybody shaves my head. Why did I choose him? Relevance. If you have an opportunity to do something, do it so well that people will call for you again. Don't mess up jobs. Don't mess up opportunities. People who don't take advantage of opportunities can never become relevant to men. You may just have one chance to play somebody's ear. Plate it so well that people say, now we don't play this ear. But we keep messing opportunities. Doing things the way we like. Become relevant. Add value. Relevance has nothing to do with money. It has much more to do with character. The person. You don't have money, but you can give advice. I want to ask you a question. What can you do? If you say nothing, then you need to go and fast. If at this age of your life, you don't know what you can do, you are in problem. You are in confusion. And the devil will destroy your life. You must come to the point where you are focused. Ha! Nothing creates focus in destiny like the discovery of your purpose of creation. David said, one thing do I desire. Not one thing. I know what I'm called to be. I know what I pursue. I know where I'm called to be relevant. I practice. I train. I prepare. I am in that particular field that every time I come to preach, I must preach in a way that you want to hear me again tomorrow. That's relevance. When I start prophesying, I must prophesy accurately so you don't do things anyhow. If not, I tell you, you will become poor, useless and rejected. No, there is, listen to me here, no matter how the world is busy, the world can never close its ear to a voice of solution. No matter how this world is busy, nobody turns his back on a man that carries what he wants. Nobody, not even Satan. Nobody. Nobody. What can you do? It is good to sit down and admire people. But there is something you that can make you admirable. Look for that thing. Bring it out. Some people, it can be the gift of motivation to talk. What can you do? The king had a dream. They said there is one guy in this nation. That guy can interpret dream. They didn't call for him to come and preach. They knew his area. When it comes to dreams, they said, no, leave it for Daniel. This man can do this thing. What can you do? What is your relevance? That's how Daniel moved from the David moved from the back and began playing for the king. My God. He didn't write application. Listen to me. There are many jobs even in this town. Unless somebody recommends you, you cannot have that job. But nobody can recommend you if you are not relevant. If you become relevant, you can be in church now. People are talking about you in a place, in a company. No, there's one girl, that girl. No, if you do it, if I. But who can recommend you? They recommend you by reason of your relevance. Don't waste your life away. You will regret it. In this time of your strength and glory and valor, don't waste your life. Put in yourself that you become relevant. You can't sit down with your phone for 5 hours chatting. You are becoming irrelevant. You know something? There's one thing about, there's a law of treasure. Anything that can be easily found is not precious. That's the law. Precious things means that they are not easily found. That's why to see gold, you must dig. To see stones, they are everywhere. If you must be precious in each generation, forget. By understanding of your relevance, you will separate yourself. So you can put a price on yourself. Put a price on yourself. No, don't be cheap. Put a price on yourself. Become relevant. Don't say, man of God, my family is poor. It's not my family is poor in this story. If you focus on the circumstance of your birth, it will hinder you from pursuing the purpose of your birth. You were born in a poor family, but were you born to be poor? That's the question. Because how you were born, where you were born, and when you were born is not as important as why you were born. Why was I born? The Lord Jesus was born in a manger among sheep, animal. But he was a king. So the circumstance of my birth is not strong enough to destroy the glory of my destiny. Unless I begin to think like that. My family is poor. I don't care. If my family is poor, then God sent me to bring riches there. Listen to me. There is one mindset I have. I see myself as the solution to my family. Not a problem. So whatever I met in my family, I understand I've been empowered by God to solve. There is complain is the language of lazy people. There's no time to complain. Do the work and get the results. If you have to train in the field the whole night, train. If you have to sing the whole night, sing. Don't come and give excuses why you fail. There is no excuse is good enough for a failure. You see this word? This word has no time for failure. Today, people can be calling you great. You fail to move. Oh man, leave you. In this world, nobody loves nobody. People love what people can do. End of quote. Don't be looking for love. It's a lie. Nobody will love you. People love your relevance to them. And that is true. Are you following me? So what are you going to do? That's the question. Look at Esther. They were looking for a queen. She became queen. This is relevance. And the time came. They brought a law that all the Jews will be killed. Everybody was crying and was frightened. And Esther, one little girl of about 18 years, she was not up to 20 yet, she walked to the king. She said, reverse that law. The king reversed it. A child. That's relevance. She was a girl, a youth, yet by relevance, she could control the king of Babylon. A king that had over 20 million people over him was listening to a little girl. Relevance. How relevant are you? How relevant are you? How relevant are you? No excuses. No reason to fail. If you accommodate failure, I'm telling you, you are a disgrace to the kingdom of God. In the same exam where people pass, you fail. Don't give any excuse that I failed because you fail. Go back and work out and succeed. There is no excuse for failure. If you have failed, work out and do better. When we fail, we don't make excuses. Neither do we give up. We come back and do 10 times better. If you are the kind of person that make excuses for failure, I can assure you, you will never ever be great. Never. Because you will have a reason for every failure. It is because now, there is no reason. Your family is not your problem. Your background is not your problem. As a man thinketh, so is he. You accept to be poor, you shall be poor. You accept to be a failure, you are a failure. Listen to me, as a child of God, do not derive your identity from your experiences or from the opinions of men. You are not what you have gone through. Neither are you what people have said. In other words, a sister, she has disappointment in marriage, about 5 men, and they call her useless girl. By that experience, she now start thinking she's useless. Mm-mm. You cannot define who you are by your experience. You can only be defined by God who created you. It is the producer that gives the identity of the product, not the customers. Customers do not give identity to product. Listen to me. The identity of every product is given by the producer and not the consumer. When you go to the store to buy, for example, you say, I want Coca-Cola. Is it me who call it like that? It is the consumer. Even they call it Manawa, I'll say I want Manawa. Whatever name the producer puts, as long as I go for the product, I will call it the way I call it. Now, if I now go and say, okay, I don't want it to call it Coca-Cola, I want to call it Copa Gaga. And I say, go to the store, give me Copa Gaga. The master says, wait, give me Copa Gaga now. Copa Gaga, wait, that's just for the. The man look at it. It's not Coca-Cola. I say, no, me, I don't want to say Coca-Cola. I want to say Copa Gaga. That is those are symptoms of madness. They can arrest you and take you for prayer. So, as a consumer, I don't have right. Now, why do you allow men who did not create you give you an identity? So, me, I am Kevin, is a product of God. And God sent me on earth. And I come on earth. This man cannot tell me I am useless. Did you create me? Only the producer of the product that knows the identity and the true value of that product. If God say I am the light of the world, you can't cover me. If God say I'm more than a conqueror, I cannot be down. If God say I'm the head, so the only thing I have to do is to start thinking of myself according to what God says about me. Even if you fail Jesus 10 times, never accept you are a failure. Because failing is an experience, not an identity. Because a man may fail today, tomorrow he passes. It's an experience. They say, John the Baptist, who are you? He stay quiet. He said, are you the prophet? When you don't know who you are, men will tell you who you are not. You must be confident. You will stand up, you look at your family, your father, your mother have no pay rent. Tell them, mama, don't worry. Give me 10 years, I'll build you a house. That time, it looks foolish when you are talking to 10 years come. Because every success begins with the mind. As a man thinketh. The purpose of social media is to corrupt your mind, to make you think and see yourself in who you are not. That is why social media is 90% fake. There's something they call filters on pictures. Filters. What is the purpose of filters? To change your face. On social media, that's social media. It is a fake platform to show fakeness. You can add anything you want to add. But no matter what you add there, the truth of real life will always face you. When you stand to the mirror, you will not see filter, you will see your face. Are you with me? See, hey, look at how she is. Now phone. When you answer, she says, it's me. You say, no, it's not you. Somebody wants to snap a picture. Stand at this. No. Why? I want to understand if there's a mystery of this potential. Maybe I don't know. I'm sorry. I want to know the mystery of. Why can you, if you start to snap, what's going to happen? I'm waiting for women that will snap straight. There's a problem of and they always like pose. I want to understand. You want to kick a free kick? Like, what are you trying to do? Now Oluwa, you show me Buto. Say now Oluwa, is this Oluwa? So. When you are showing your buttocks, you will be only relevant for sex. That is the truth. People buy what you sell. What you show is what you advertise. If all your pictures you want to snap, make sure that they must see your breast, so you must pap. You must take it from under so you can show some weight. Pap, just lean at home, oh, na glory of God. You not a musnaya, but be the last glory of God. Na lie. And when you show that breast, the men that come after you, they come for what you advertise. They come to. They were coming for that. I don't understand. Anyone who come to me want to sleep with me is what you are selling. If you were selling something else, they'll buy something else. You can listen to me. Don't never blame customers. Customers come for what you advertise. Is it true? If all a young man does is to wear chain, wear singlet, stand on picture like that on Facebook every day, what do you think? Somebody can employ you. So I have a company I'm not able to employ. Then, although you have graduated to, they want to see your picture. Am I crazy to employ? All your pictures. Nobody will employ you. That's true. So when we speak of relevance, there's something about relevance. In relevance, there is image management. Manage your image. Don't appear anyhow. Don't manage your image. Manage your image. If you don't want people to call you what you are not, make sure you don't dress like what you are not. Manage your image. Appear well. Look like where you are going to. I'm telling you. Bible says Joseph was in prison. He said the king, they told him the king is calling for you. He said, and Joseph shaved and changed his dress. The king did not say, come and be governor. He didn't know if they would call him and send him back to prison. But he understood, if I'm going to stand before the king, if I stand with my prison clothes, I may go back there. Let me appear before the king like a future governor. And he swaggerized himself. When he stood before the king, he, Bible say, as long as he was in prison, he did not shave. But when the king was calling, he said, what? He looked for his last money when I shave. Change his garment. When he stood before the king, he looked kinglicious. Manage your image. Because a person may have an ability and a talent, but because you cannot properly manage your image, it corrupts your name. Because your name is tied to your image. They say, that guy get bad character. Now that your business don't spoil. No, you can play the hair well, they'll just spoil. He get bad character. Once the enemy attacks your image, they have attacked your name. If they attack your name, they have attacked your relevance. That's why if they want to fight a man of God, they must say Prophet Kevin is fake. No matter how I prophesy and do miracle, when you hear fake or it use charm, now all that, it makes you hate me without knowing me. Because image is your God say, let us make man in our what? Look at the first thing God gives man. Image. God knows that the greatest thing is image. Nothing brings conviction like what people see. Somebody may hear something, but seeing is stronger than hearing. Manage your image. So understand this. Social media is an image game. There are some pictures you have posted. Don't worry. After 10 years, someone will bring you up to break your marriage. So you are careful, because anything you post there stays. Image. Manage your image very well. In image management is when we work on our character. You don't behave anyhow because you know that. And listen to me. Once a person has a purpose, you sit down, you check what you want to be, and you work on yourself first. Work on yourself and project that image. You get there. Nothing is impossible in this world. Nothing. Nothing. Esther was an orphan. She became a queen. Joseph, a prisoner, he became a governor. Daniel, a slave, he became a prime minister. What can you not do if you can understand how to work on what? Relevance. So, what do I need to do to be relevant? Number one, purity. What? Purity. Daniel chapter 1 verse 8 says, and Daniel refused to eat the king's food to defile himself. There was a certain lifestyle people had to live. Daniel said, I will not live that lifestyle. Number one is purity. Someone say purity. Say purity. I've noticed this. Every person who became relevant as a youth, they were pure. Potiphar's wife came to sleep with Daniel. He refused. What is that? Purity. When the king was looking for a wife, he looked for virgins. What is virginity? Purity. He said, and Daniel refused to defile himself. Listen to me, my dear people. There is a lifestyle out there. If you follow the people of the world, you will not experience the glory of your God. Don't dress like them. Don't talk like them. Don't act like them. We have our own standard. Purity. Purity. If you don't have value for purity, you can never ever fulfill destiny. It is, you must be pure. Sexual purity, emotional purity, physical purity. Be pure. Be pure. In the world, they say use condom. In Christ, we say abstain. Our standard can never be lower down. In the standard of God is purity. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall. So purity is a requirement to experience the grace and the glory of God. If you are not pure, you must go back and look at yourself. What are the elements of your life that displease God? Always ask yourself, what am I doing that God does not like? Don't behave anyhow. Listen to me. There is no great man, even in the world, that does not have discipline. I'm telling you. Look at great people. You hear, I walk from 8 to 8. It is only, even the man who made Facebook is not on Facebook every day, like people who do not make Facebook. Because he must be working to create something else. You cannot be pure if you don't discipline yourself. It is a choice. There is a choice to watch pornography. Choose not to watch it. Any person who is conscious, it is the consciousness of your destiny that enables you to discipline yourself in the presence of sin. When you are conscious that this sleeping with this girl can ruin my life, you will have, listen to me, everybody is tempted, all of us. But what sustains some of us is that when we remember where we are going to, we'll say this thing I'll not for you. Remember where you are going to. Look at Samson, a mighty man of God. He died cheaply because he slept with the woman, Delilah. Look at Solomon, all the wisdom God gave him, he ended anyhow. Because he went and got married to 1,000 women. Look at David, the great prophet of God. Because of one Bathsheba, God put a curse on his family. To today, he's still there. But look at one Joseph. No anointing. No prophecy. Discipline. He ended well. Look at Samson. He did not end well. He died in the camp of the enemy. Look at Solomon. Samson is the symbol of power. It didn't end well. Look at Solomon, the symbol of wisdom. It didn't end well. Look at David, the symbol of the anointing. It did not end well. But look at Joseph, the symbol of discipline, the fear of God. He ended well. So which one do you choose? If you have the power of Samson, the wisdom of Solomon, the anointing of David, but not the fear of God of Joseph, you will end poorly. Purity. Value purity. If you sit back in your room alone and there's a picture of a naked woman on your phone, nobody may be seeing you, but Papa God is seeing you. That picture is corrupting your heart. Discipline yourself. I don't want this thing. Stop it. Check some things and shift from them. There are some boys that are coming to the name of marriage. They are time wasters. They never go marry you. They're not going to marry you. Time wasters. They give you an engagement ring, it becomes a university course. 6 years, I'm still studying you. So somebody, your friend went to university level one. Your fiance came and engaged you. Your friend now has a master degree. Your fiance didn't study you. Even in university, they are finished. His own course of you has not finished. At the end now, my mommy say, man, no married. Because he... Time wasters. Hallelujah. And there are also women. Fire extinguishers. You carry serious anointing that they have been dreaming about you. Eh? I don't know. I don't understand the dream. In my dream now, I was flowing some water. Then you came. You held me now. As you heard me, I don't want to see we're going there. When I enter the church, we enter the church now, and also Papa Suleiman was praying for me and you. So I don't know what it means. You know what it means. Shut up, you know. What are you trying to tell me? Come here. They look so innocent, so I don't know what it means. You know, after about 2 weeks, another dream again. This is another dream. I am man of God. This other dream. This other dream now. I saw myself was my vision. I want to see now. We're in a party. Then I was not seeing them. All of a sudden, I now saw you appear. Yeah, I appear. Now he's a kappa. Come on. And he appear. He appear. One time, I think that was 7 years ago, one girl came and told me that she loved me. He said, "Chai, man of God, I like you." I said, "Eh?" Then he said, "Chai, see her lips as they red. If I for kiss her, man." I said, "Eh?" I said, "What he?" He said, "Chai, see her lips as they red. One time she need a kiss." I said, "Eh?" You know what I answer her? I said, "Sister, last 2 months, your mother had, I think her mother was fibroid. Your mother had fibroid. I pray for her, she was here." She said, "Yeah." I said, "Okay, if I sleep with you now and tomorrow your mother has cancer, who will heal your mother?" He said, "Benatruo." I said, "Pass, boy." Listen to me. Think about consequence. It is sweet to eat the fruit, do you have to pay the price for eating it? Don't forget, the price of disobedience is always much more than you can afford. You cannot pay back. It will cost you your life. It will cost you your destiny. Value purity and be pure. Refuse to compromise. The king said, "As you hear the sound of the trumpet, everybody must bow." 3 guys, the whole nation bow. More than 10,000 people bow, and because everybody was bowing down, 3 men stood up. Anytime you stand out, you must be noticed. When everybody was down, they saw. They said, "What are these guys? 3 guys standing. What are these 3 guys?" And they went, "You are not bowing down. No, put them in the fire." And they say, "Oh King, live forever. Whether God save us or not, we will not bow. No fornication. No masturbation. No, I am no pornography. I'm not bowing." The king said, "Put them in fire. If you stand for God, God will stand with you. If you want to be pure, sexually pure, God will give you grace to be pure." Don't say, "Man of God, the thing hard though." He had, because you are trying to be pure by the flesh. You cannot fight sexual desire by the flesh. Now, lie. According to biology, it is part of your system. They say a normal man has erection at least 7 times a day. How do you do with 7 erections in 1 day if it's not grace? So you need grace to control yourself. So these things that happen in your body is not marine spirit, it's biology. Tell me, my body is feeling one time. That's biology. But the feeling of your body is not an excuse. So skin begin is crash. I don't say I just go. So if you mean say with the hungry juice, you go enter my store, take the juice, then we'll beat you in the teeth. So you cannot use desire as an excuse for wrongdoing. You cannot say, "I stole because I was hungry." Hunger is not an excuse for stealing. Same thing. Sexual desire is not an excuse for fornication. If you have that desire, get counseling. Woman, go to counseling from a woman. Don't go and tell a man, "Sir, I don't know, I'm having sexual desires." Yes, a woman, it will slap them off. No man, slap them. Man, I'm going to slap them. Paul slap their head. They're coming to tell us, "Men, I have a social desire." You are telling me, "I'm a gynecologist. Come over here." So I don't know what to do. I don't know. Go and tell a woman, "I beg not to tell that cat in there." Same thing for men. Go and tell men. Do like that. Amen. You know, some of you girls are falling into trap because you confided in the wrong person. I'm just helping you. I'm saying the truth. It's not just funny, it's the truth. Amen. Say purity. Shout it louder. Louder, louder, louder. Louder, louder, louder. You need to become pure. Purity. Number 2. Excellence. Someone say excellence. Daniel chapter 6 verse 3. He said, and Daniel was excellent. Friend, it's not enough to have an ability. You must become excellent. You must become what? You know, excellence is what makes, creates a difference. For example, okay, let me bring you 2 bottles of water. Let me show you something. But this one is a bit different now, but it's almost the same thing I did. Now, watch this now. This is 2 bottles of water. Okay. These are 2 products, not so. Watch. The content is the same. The 2 bottles, right? It's the same. But Do you know that this one looks as if it's crazy in that season? Do you know that? If you go out to buy, which one will you buy if you see these two things in the shop? This one. Why? Because this thing here makes it excellence. Excellence is branding your service to attract men to your gift. Excellence is a brand. It's like, let me say, who can I use? Well, let me look to the applicated Rasta. Rasta. Is it Rasta or Rasta? Rasta. Okay, you stand up. This is Rasta. Okay, good. That's three. Come. Three Rasta. Rasta. Not Rasta. Farias. All right. Turn behind. Let me see. Turn. Now. Okay, sister, turn. I want to shake her something. See the edge of her hair. You see this one? This one already is winning all of them already. This last one. This one, well, it's a style. This one looks like a threat. Now, if I want to play, if someone wants to play the Rasta here, obviously, I would recommend this one. Not because her own is the best. She's presented, she has done a style. You see this style? This is what they call excellence. Adding something to what you are doing. I'm not saying your own is not nice, so everyone always nice. I'm not saying pastor say my own advice. Go and sit down. Everyone is nice. Excellence. Listen to me. Excellence is you can only be excellent by being committed in perfecting yourself in what you're called to do. Okay, some people come and say, okay, special number, they come. Church, this is my special number. Mighty God, Ale be the name. Oh, shaka baga baga baga. Faithful God, you are worthy to receive all the praise, you alone. Is it because it is church that we are stupid? Now, this is what church people do. Listen to me. I am not first forced to buy your stuff because you're an ambassador. Forget that thing. You will sew my dress, my trousers are my knee, like Michael Jackson. I'll not come again there. How can you sew somebody a suit? You wear a suit, it's like a jacket. it's like petit coat. Please sit down. My point is this. Excellence is what? Excellence makes your difference. If you want to sing, train well. You play somebody said the whole night should be making. Aye. You know, some people play their head. They will, be careful of your medulla oblongata. This thing that I drag it. Okay, I'm telling you. Be excellent. They enter your restaurant. We call for food. Food come with flies. I don't know what we are eating. The flies. Who come there again? Be excellent. In excellence, there is cleanliness. You can't be excellent unless you give yourself to proper preparation. Excellent men are relevant. If you are excellent, you must be relevant. To be excellent means to do things well. Not half-half. Be excellent. If you come and do something for me well, and somebody has the same issue, I'll recommend you to them. Say excellence. If you want to dress, dress well. If you want to preach, preach well. If you want to play football, play well. A child of God must be the best. You are the head and not the tail. You put it, engage yourself. Everything I do, now I do even music. I rap. But my rap is, I can say sometimes, 10 times better than some people that rap. And me, I'm not a rapper, they are rappers. Because I take at least 1 month to do one song. That's how I do. I'll take it, I'll take the instrumental, I will write one song for 1 month. When I come and record, I record in 5 minutes. But after that, you hear, you cannot believe that is a man of God that sounds like that. Because you don't go there and shout, grace. In that place is ability. And ability is perfected by practice to gain forth excellence. If you neglect your gift and your talent, you can't be excellent. Give yourself to what you can do. Night and day, work it out. You see the way when you just do something, people are caught by it. Excellence. You know why? Because in these our days, there are too many people with too many things. The only way for you to make a difference is to become excellent in your own. What can you do? Listen to me. There are many pastors. But now, no matter where you go, you will miss my preaching. But there are many pastors who, I'm not saying I'm the best preacher, but there is a way I preach. My preaching comes with every aspect of life. It comes even with joke. when you go, there must be something that catches you. Can I shock you? All these things, I train them. When you train yourself, your spirit man becomes apt to receive excellence from above. Become excellent. But you can't be excellent if you are not committed or diligent. You know, me, for example, if somebody's arranging the house for me, if you put dresses and one shift, like I have high blood, everything must be on the same line. That's why I'll just come and say, if you push like this, I must align them, because there's something in my mind, something must be well done. Listen to me, you don't have any, it is one opportunity you can take advantage and you take over. One time, I remember, before I was playing football, when we were playing football, sometimes white men came to sign some of our friends. The man, when I was making with ball, he thought he was Ronaldo. There's not only signing, the team drove him away. A man who could play well. But that day, when it was opportunity, I said, now what did that play? Did you play? He left excellence and began to impress. When you go after impressing people, you lose ability and excellence. Excellence is not to impress people. Mm-mm. No. Excellence is to give the best of you in whatever you do. Somebody will come and give me a gift that they draw me. How they draw my lens in my ear. I said, I don't get ear. Why you draw me so? I can't draw me, my ear is behind my head. I said, Papa, for your birthday. I said, this is, I rebuke this Obanje spirit. This is not me. Excellence. Glory be to God. Say excellence. Shout it louder. Shout it louder. Shout it louder. Louder, 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 louder. Excellence. Oh, thank you, Father. I hear the Lord saying somebody is being baptized with the spirit of excellence. If you are writing an exam, pass well. Don't give us excuse that you not pass well. If you are sewing clothes, sew well. Be the best. Listen to me. I have a standard for my life. If I'm not the best, I don't rest. It must be well done. Because as I'm saying, only one opportunity can change your life. I'm telling you, if you handle one well, it can open you doors to change your life. But if you mess up opportunities, I am not saying that you should be a hypocrite. No, excellence should be something of all the time, not once in a while. Make it a habit. For example, David killed the lion. Did anybody give him anything? He killed the bear. Did they give him anything? But when he killed Goliath, did they give him something? You see? So Goliath is not the first he kills. He killed the lion for nothing. He was working on excellence. He killed the bear. So you may be doing things now and you are not paid. Don't worry. Keep doing it. There is something that will come and you'll be paid for it. That is the law of life. You may start plaiting people's hair. Don't ask for money. Just plait their hair excellently. When they will recommend you, the next person will come and pay. If you are too focused on money, your life will go nowhere. Focus on yourself. Don't take your phone. You see this girl selling dress. I'm not saying I close now. I think I close fine now. Some other time, you think, hey, no, I go send a mesh. Now mesh fine. I go send a, what kind of confusion is that? Look for your own. That person you admire, they so much work on their own, you admire. If you also work on your own, we will admire you too. Are you following me? Rise on your feet.